In this video, we will look at pinning charts. Pinning charts are small tables of numbers that show you which pin segments to put into the cores and in what order. We'll navigate to the pinning charts page. Just as with the key biddings page, you must select a set of individual keys from the schema to enable the View Pinning Charts button. Remember the individual key groups highlight in orange when hovered over in the schema. Let's select the AAA group of 64 individual keys, then click the View Pinning Charts button. All the pinning charts are displayed for all of the keys in the selected group. The pin segments are depicted as they would be positioned within a core, with the face of the core being on the right. This means the bow of a key inserted into the core would be on the right, and the tip of the key would be on the left. The pin segments in the A row are the pointed ones that contact the key. If we print all, the charts will be formatted to fit as many as possible on each printed page. Notice that my print software indicates that it will take 3 sheets of paper to print these 64 pinning charts. But if I switch from portrait layout to landscape layout, it would take only 2 sheets of paper. If you are printing a large set of pinning charts, it's good to preview both formats before confirming the print action. While landscape layout may work best in some cases, portrait layout may work best in others. If you only want to print selected charts, you can use the checkboxes to indicate which ones you want. I'll select a few, then click the Print Selected button. That's all there is to printing pinning charts in Key Calculus.